bronze building in red, figuring that a rock painting of the Sea Shells are part of the Coast Salish tribes. Some members of the Salish group did carve in the rocks. But in this area, all of the artwork are painting. Paint is some mixture of okra and berries. Salmon roe has gone into it. Jack Marvelous lost, otherwise I'd be selling it at Coast Paint. Lasted for 200 years in a town like us. That sounds pretty good. Further up inlet, we'll have a chance to show you a spec and a rock painting that's very different in style. This one is a series of symbols that I can't even begin to guess at what they mean. Further up inlet, this one that's going to have a chance to look at it. It's very definitely a drawing of something quite different. Wild night, we're not allowed to sound the name.
Jumped over the inlet and burnt pockets on the shoreline behind us.
fire of that size creates a lot of its own environmental impacts, especially wind. It's been terrifying to see those escapes jump across and start to burn on the other side.
Engine
Captain Vancouver was rowing when he came up here. He left the ship down in the Vancouver area and rowed through these inner inlets to explore and look for the Northwest Passage. He rowed all through Vancouver Harbor, all around Howe Sound, up the Sunshine Coast, all the way up to this inlet, to the head of the inlet. Discouraged at not finding the Northwest Passage, turned and rowed back to Vancouver to pick up his main ships. Now that whole trip, that whole rowing trip took 5 days. Bend and raise a blister.
land. Need a wider angle. Chatterbox Falls.
Yeah.
It's got quite the spray, yeah. Well, head back down. Yeah, we head down. Whoa.
Yes.
Pretty scary stuff. Okay. So. No, I'm gonna keep it up. So we're for a bit. Oh, okay. So we're on Princess Louise Inlet. No. Princess Louise Inlet. And there's little waterfalls all along the sides of the bank. And the mountains go up like 7,000 feet. Glaciers up at the top and places. And this little piece right here is McDonald Park, is it? Well, this guy named McDonald owned it. And the other big owner in the neighborhood, a whole sound, was a guy named Hamilton. Hamilton wanted to develop the whole thing. And there is a little resort right at the mouth here called Malibu?
Young Life Malibu Club.
Young Life Malibu Club, okay. Well, turns out Hamilton never did get it all developed. It's not clear exactly why. But at any rate, somewhere around 1950, much of the property passed into forestry company hands. And apparently, they're on the verge of cutting down the forests around the sides of this inlet, which is something that simply will happen. People don't think twice about it. That's just part of how things are done. As the boat operators put it, since 1950, they've bore the costs of holding. What would you think the costs of holding are, Ray? Taxes?
Probably less. Crop, treated like crop
land,
wait for it to mature before you
can
harvest it.
And then get taxed on the harvest? Probably. Let's see, Ray wants that one.
Is that the right one?
Yeah.
One with all the wood on it?
Yeah. Those look pretty nice. They're nice looking dinghy too. And you want it delivered in this setting, right?
Mm-hmm.
Denominational Christian group started in the late 40s in the southern states.
two in there? They're okay?
This is the Tall Blue Resort for kids. This is a great place.
Right here, folks.
Thanks.
Do they have shifts on the waterfront or something to spell?
I know.
What was the bead bar? You just go up and pick out the beads that they want, and then fishing stuff in here. And this is all teenage kids?
Yeah.
Who's not blinking, is it?
No.
Good.
Not right now.
Huh?
Not right now.
No, that's good. So, we're heading to the ice cream bar.
Mm-hmm.
Up front. We have them all set up for you.
Huh? Yeah?
Okay. Here, I'll grab them and get them to
do it again. What's up, guys?
We're going to
see if it's in there.
Oops. Okay, go ahead.
Pool.
Mm-hmm.
Right over the inlet there.
Off over to where you're looking. Let's get back on.
And that's where another one of our property staff stays. And then we have a few other buildings. You can't quite see them all. That's their girl summer staff is over there, the summer staff coordinator, and some more property staff.
What is it?
Peach, lemon, iced tea.
Does anybody have any questions or anything? We do have an adult camp.
We do.
I can give you a brochure on that. It's in September. We have adults that come up. They do everything we can for students.
Really?
Yeah. We also have an outer dock. I don't know if you all have seen it when you come in through here. But it's on the ground over that way. And then we have skiing, and all that wakeboarding.
Right over the narrows.
Thank you. Right here we have Main Street. It's where we have our Totem Trader, which is our store. We have Big Squawka right here, which is where all the kids meet.
It's great. This is great here.
They just redid the floors in here. Yeah. They just redid those floors too. We have the linen nook right over here, which is where all the bedding, linens, towels, all the housekeeping is done out of the linen nook. We have the work crew. When they've finished working in their actual positions, they come and just they'll get assigned jobs to go out and sweep or do just like different cleaning, vacuuming, that kind of thing.
So everybody's involved with the care place. Okay. Okay. That's neat.
I'll get to the history, but this used to be a resort. It was originally built as a resort, and this was kind of like, I think, the ballroom kind of thing. Mm. And then back here we have what we call Little Squawka, and there's a fireplace in there. I think it was like a lounge when it was a resort. We have the medicine man here. Every week we have two doctors come in and bring their families. There are doctors that are on call. And whenever we have any problems, they have their little pagers and we page them and they come in and deal with it. Usually we just have like, the worst we have is like stitches or like sprained ankles and that kind of thing. Their families, it's kind of like a vacation too for them. So
sure.
They get to come out and help us out and then they get to come. Here's the office, which is where I work. And I can get some brochures. Is anybody interested in either Young Life brochures?
Actually, both of them.
Malibu, and then we also have the adult camp. Mm-hmm. You want anybody? Mm-hmm. Everybody want one?
So you like it here? Huh?
We have an adult camp, which I think is in September. Well, okay. Yeah, August and May. Anybody interested in
the adult camp? Thank you, Kelly. What, Lauren, Derek? What, you like Lauren, Derek?
Above Main Street is the Lilouette Deck, which is a guy's cabin, and the Nutley Deck is right behind it. And then on the very top, we have the Sweetwater Deck, which is the adult guest deck.
No,
I presume it's all the boys here. We have the Sitka Cabin.
Yes, that's. What was over there?
Hmm?
What were these units? It's quite a nice place.
Yeah. It's $230 Canadian funds for adults.
Really?
Yeah.
Fishing and water.
water sports of all sorts. And
I think we have 15 minutes.
It's
fabulous.
Right here we have one of the largest totem poles. Late 30s by Tom Hamilton, who was the inventor. He invented the prop propeller, and he and his wife had just been up here, I guess, down at Chatterbox Falls, and had seen this area. And his wife really liked this area. There was
What are the ages?
High school. It's usually juniors and seniors, some sophomores. It just depends on the areas. Usually campers can only come once. And so it depends on the areas how they bring them. We have adult camps, like I said, and then there's also, I think there's some at the beginning, they come like each spring, they have Their leaders are their leaders that have been in their high school with them, know them, and that they do all the counseling and all that kind of stuff. The summer staff and work crew are just running the camp, basically.
So they come as a group from certain school?
Yeah, they usually come with their high school or their area.
Okay. And what's the size of those groups? Those are
a
few kids or many?
Some kids, sometimes they'll just bring, four or five. Other times they'll bring, 100. So it just depends on the area. Like I'm from Knoxville, Tennessee, and we go to Frontier Ranch, which is in Colorado, and we have to go for 3 different weeks because we have so many kids. Like we have to spread out, and that's what we had Portland West here for about 3 or 4 weeks, and a couple other areas had to spread out over 3 or 4 different weeks because they had so many kids. Because they don't like the camp to be all one area; they like to have different areas.
Yeah, there's real value in that.
Anybody have any questions?
This is amazing.
Oh, no. He was built out of, and so he could not work here anymore. I don't know that they necessarily have someone here.
Yeah, he was right down.
And we have a couple of cabins. You can see one right here. There's another one behind the trees. One was the honeymoon suite for when this was a resort, and now it houses our assignment team. We put in a speaker in the program staff to do all things. They have a theme like this week, their chicken farm. And they usually just do all kinds of things. So. And then also another one of sidewalks.
Thank you. Mm-hmm.
You're supposed to navigate meter 99, too.
Okay. I guess this would be kind of outskirts of Vancouver in a way. 99 heading out north here for a while. It's about 7 o'clock in the evening. So it's kind of that, just, it's Monday?
It's Tuesday. Just kind of. See a speed limit.
60 in the curve, so it's at least 70 probably in the straight. Probably 70 or 80. Ray's going 130 just because she wants to get there. Channel in particular, the Howe Sound, although I guess back here the Queen Charlotte Channel is done.